This video is on implicit differentiation. Let's get started. You press second alpha to put the letters in my code here to get to my menu, and then you press alpha again to get to 8 in the close parentheses. And then you press enter, up comes my menu. I'm already at the implicit differentiation one, but you can scroll, you know, up to whatever you need here. If you're after this subject, then that's what you do. I'm going to press the enter and get into my program. I give you an example of it. I can use that here so I can remember it here. Alpha, you have to press the alpha first to put anything in that line on the titanium. So we're going to do alpha y cubed plus y squared minus 5 times y minus x squared, press the equal sign, and minus 4. You have to use the minus beside, you know, to the left of the enter button, not the one that is the takeaway minus sign. And then you see what you've entered and check whether it's correct or not. If it is, you press OK. And here's the system. You differentiate both sides with respect to x, the left side and the right side of the equation, which we did here. And the answer is minus 2x equals 0. You can see minus x squared, the first derivative of that is 2 minus 2x squared. And the other y is that this is all partial differentiation, which you get in calculus 2 mainly. And with respect to whatever, even though there's y's or z's or x's, when you're respect to x, you just do the derivative of the x variables in that function and leave the others alone. Well, that's what we've done here. And then you take the x and move it to the right side here, changing the sign, of course, that's algebra. When you change signs with the equal sign, you have to change it. And then you're going to take the derivative of the left side with respect to y. And this is the answer here, 3y squared plus 2y minus 5, which is the first derivative of all these indications up here. And then the answer is dy dx. You've taken derivatives of both. And you take the right side and divide it by the left side, and here's your answer. I give you the option to evaluate it at a point. Sometimes the problems ask you to do that. So we can do that now. You have to press alpha and you can put in 7. And then maybe alpha minus 6. And here's the xy point. Check if it's right. If it's wrong, you can change it. Otherwise, we're going to say it's okay. And notice that the 7 goes into the x's and the y's go into the, and the minus 6 goes into the y's. You put that down on your paper. And here's the answer, 2 over 13, which is the slope of the line, rise over run. Notice that if you take two increments up on the y-axis and go over 13 on the x-axis and draw a line from that point down through the center, 0, 0, you've got, that's the slope of that line. However, it's not a tangent line. A tangent line is touching the point that you indicated or asked to evaluate things at, and I tell you that here just to remind you. And of course, if you want to get that, you have to do the y equals mx plus b equation, which is in my my programs also. I'll show you here. Go back to the main menu, number 3, I'll press 3 and go back to the main menu. You can see that here's the equation of a tangent line, and that'll set that line right on that point if you graphed it. Pretty neat, huh? EveryStepCalculus.com. Check out this program and other programs.